Welcome back, students. You are listening the discussion on geography, and this session mainly for the class 7 students. What we are going to know today inside our art is the part of geography, chapter number 2. So inside our art, what is the art? First recap regarding this. Whatever you have learned in class 6, art is a planet. Why it is? What type of planet? It is the planet which has a rocky surface. That rocky surface means the lithosphere. So the Earth surface, it is solid. It is a planet. You have learned in the junior class already. In class 6 already you have learned. So what we are going to learn today, we are going to learn about the specific thing of the chapter, that is, what is the structure of the Earth interior. We are going to know this one. And this Earth interior structure, we are going to know this one. So first of all, I want to say an example. What type of interior structure of this planet? I think all you have seen onion. What is the onion? What is the structure of the onion? Onion structure, it is layers. There are lots of layers in an onion. If we peel off, we used to see that layers after layers, and such layers after layers leads to the core. In the same way, the Earth is such type of planet which has also lots of layers, and such layers, about the such layers, we are going to know in this class. So what we are getting? The Earth has the three prominent section in the interior. The first of all, I want to show in a diagram. What is, I'm going to show a diagram here. The first one, it is known as the crust or lithosphere. Next one, the second layer, it is known as the mantle. And third one, it is known as the core. So there are the three prominent layers are there. The first of all, it is known as the crust. What is the characteristics of the crust? We have tried to know. It is lithosphere, it is also known as the lithosphere where we are living. So it is made by the solid materials. So this particular section, it is made by the solid material. Solid materials are there. There is also the cover of what? Cover of the rock. There is also the cover of soil. We will come to know about the what is referred as the rock later on. First of all, description regarding the inside of the earth. Next one, it is known as the next layer, it is known as mantle. And last one, it is known as the core. What is the nature of mantle? The nature of mantle, it is in the semi-liquid condition or the liquid condition. So it is totally different from the upper portion. It is made by the liquid material, on which the earth crust is lying, and we are living on the crust. And next one, the core. Core means the deepest section. The deepest section of the earth interior, it is known as the core. There is the two sections of core. One is referred as the outer core. Another is referred as the inner core. Outer, O means outer, I means inner. So there are the three types of layers which are known as the lithosphere or the crust, next one mantle, and third of all, that is referred as the core. I think it is clear to you there are the three types of section. Next one, we are coming to know what is the thickness of the different layers and we will discuss about also the components by which they are made of. So first of all, we have to keep in mind which is known as the crust. That crust, it is variable 5 to 35 kilometer. The thickness of this particular section, it is 5 to 35 kilometer. And what is that? There are the two portions of this section of lithosphere. What is this? One is continental section. One is continental section, another is oceanic section. Continental and oceanic section, oceans are also there. So there are the two first classification of the crust. So continental crust and ocean crust, there are the two types of the section. So continental crust, it is made by the rocks, continental rocks. Both the sections, they are made by the rocks. So what is rock? So we are getting that the one word by which this particular section is made up, that is made up by rocks. What is the meaning of rocks? Any element by which the earth crust is made up, that is known as the rock. So whatever elements are there, all they are related to the rocks. So whatever mud is there, there is also soil also there, pebbles we can see. So the confusion in your mind, what is a rock? That rock's definition says about what? All the materials which are found on the lithosphere, on the crust, all they can be referred as rocks. So sand, pebble, mud, everything is referred as what? Everything is referred as the rocks. So now we are coming to that the particular details about them. The main by which the rocks are made up. Rocks are made up by minerals. So rocks and minerals. Rocks is made up by minerals. Minerals are there. So rocks, not only the rocks, their components by which it is made up, that is known as the mineral. Minerals are also found. What is referred as the mineral? The component by which the rocks are composed, they are referred as the minerals. So what is the difference between the rocks and minerals? Minerals means, obviously, the materials by which the rocks are composed. Next one, we are coming to the next section, that is the continental and the oceanic section. They are made by the specific type of rocks. What they are? The main mineral constitutes of the continental mass are silica and aluminum. For continental section, what we are getting? For continental section, we are getting silica and aluminum. Silica and aluminum. So this continental section is referred as CL. Combinedly, we can say CL. So what is the meaning of CL? CL means that the components by which this continental section is made up, that is referred as the CL. CL means SI for silica, AL means aluminum. So I think it is clear. Next one, the oceanic section, it is made by silica and magnesium. Silica and magnesium. SI, silica, MA, magnesium. Silica and magnesium combinedly referred as SIMA. Now the question, what are the characteristics of them? The characteristics of these particular materials by which the continental section and the oceanic section is made up. They have the specific characteristics. What is the characteristic? Silica and aluminum. Aluminum is comparatively light material. We have to remember it. It is light material. What is this? Continental section is made by comparatively less weighted material. Aluminum, it is light material. light material, that is why it remains in the upper side. You know that which is the heavier thing, they usually go down. If we take the example of one glass in a glass of water, if we pour the some amount of sand or some amount of sugar, the sugar they used to go interior, and they relate what they used to say about what they say about that the heavier material. But if we take the example of thermocol as it is a very light material, so they can float on it. So the crust, it is in the upper portion. Why it is in the upper portion? As this particular section is made by silica and aluminium, that is the continental section, that is why they are in the upper side. Another we are getting, that is a sima. Sima means what? Silica and magnesium. Silica and magnesium constitute the oceanic portion. So ocean, so now the question is that how we can get, if we consider this is the continental section, this can be referred as the continental section, and this is the oceanic section. So continental section, I am writing a continental section and oceanic section. This oceanic section, it remains comparatively in the down portion of the earth crust, and the thickness of this particular area, it is comparatively less. It varies mostly the 5 km, and it goes to the 35 km from the base in case of continental section. So oceanic section, it is made by the comparatively heavier material, which are known as the silica and magnesium. Magnesium is comparatively heavier than aluminium. So this is the first basic concept by which the earth crust is made up. So I am saying about the very first chapter, very first page of the chapter. So you will read, you will get such type of words. That figure number 1, 2.1 and figure 2.2 is given in your textbook. Now, we are coming to the next portion. Just beneath the crust is the mantle, which extends up to the depth of 2900 km. So what is the depth of mantle? That is 2900 km. Mantle's depth, 2900 km. Further 2900 km, this particular section extends. This is the mantle. So this particular section says about the depth 2900 km. And what will be the condition if we'll go the earth interior? If we'll go the earth interior, there will be gradual increase of the temperature. With the increasing depth, we have to remember there is also the increasing, what? Increasing of the heat. Temperature used to increase. And from this concept, we can say we are not able to get any kind of living organisms after the crust. So crustal portion, up to which kilometer we can go, maximum 6 to 7 km we can go. And next one, in the mantle portion, as it is made by the liquid material, such liquid material also calls for the volcanic eruption, the lava or magma, what they used to come out. They usually comes from the mantle section, and the depth of this, it is 2900 km. Next one, we are coming to the next portion of the chapter. The innermost layer is the core. Innermost layer is the core with a radius about the 3500 km. In your textbook, it is written that is 3500 km. 3500 km. Is the radius. So what is the meaning of radius? What is radius? If we draw a circle, this from the center to this particular distance is referred as radius. So this is the radius. So what is the length? What will be the length of this section? Obviously 3500 plus 3500 means 7000 kilometer distance we are getting. So what is the depth? That is 3500 kilometer radius means you have to add what is the depth of that particular section. The depth of this particular section is the 7000 kilometer. That is the innermost section of the core. So next one, we are coming to know about the rocks and minerals. So we will discuss about the rocks and minerals. So first thing, what we are going to know in the first chapter, first thing, what we have learned in the first portion of this chapter, we come to know about the structure of the interior of the earth. There are the three prominent phases of the, or the layers of the earth. What they are? The crust of all, the crust. Crust can be also said as the lithosphere. Next one, the mantle, and next one, the core. Core is divided into the two sections, outer core and inner core. That mantle extend up to the 2900 kilometer, and the radius of the core, the total portion, it is known as what? It has the 3500 kilometer radius. So I think it is clear what is the material by which it is made up. That we have to know, that is nickel and iron. That is why it is also referred as NiFe. Innermost layer is the core with the radius about the 3500 kilometer. It is mainly made up of nickel and iron. It is called NiFe. So what is the condition of NiFe? What is the meaning of NiFe? So this particular section, it is made by NiFe. It is made by what? It is made by NiFe. I am going to show it once again. So NiFe, this particular section, it is made by NiFe. NiFe, what is the meaning of NiFe? Nickel and ferrous. Nickel and ferrous, they are the heavier material, they are the comparatively more weighted material. That is why at the time of cooling down of the planet, at the time of formation of the earth, that most heaviest heavier material, or the materials which have the greater density, they used to settle in the innermost section. Now you may have the question in your mind, sir, iron ore is available. Iron is available in the earth crust. How it is possible? At the time of the formation of the planet, at the time of development of the lithosphere or evolution of the lithosphere, we have seen also a particular process which is known as the degassing process. The degassing process, what is this? Degassing process means from the earth interior, huge materials, they came out as lava. Means it leads to the formation of a particular layer which led to the formation of the earth crust also. Means due to the volcanic eruption, the materials which came out from the earth interior, they have constituted, they have turned into the crust due to the solidification of them, and it leads to the development of what? Development or as well as also the availability of the different kinds of minerals in the earth crust. So I think it is clear to you. Next one, rocks and minerals. What is rock? Already I have told you. What is the mineral? Already I have told you. What are the minerals? Once again, minerals means the materials by which the rocks are made of. That is referred as the minerals. So in case of minerals and the rocks, first of all, we are going to know about the different types of rocks. Now the materials by which the earth surface is made up, that we will discuss. So we are coming to this section. What is we are discussing about the rocks? So rocks means all the materials which usually help to develop the earth crust, or which used to develop the lithosphere, that is known as the rocks. So next one, what we are getting? We are getting that the types of rocks. Here rocks, the types we are going to discuss. Types. There are the three types of rocks. First of all, igneous rocks. Next one, metamorphic rock. Next one, sedimentary rock. So igneous rock, sedimentary rock, and igneous, sedimentary, and metamorphic rocks are the three types of rocks which are found here. So next one, what we are getting? What is the meaning of the igneous rock? Igneous rocks means the rock which are made, first of all, what we are getting, we are igneous. Igneous rocks. Igneous rocks means it is made by the volcanic eruption. So lava and magma, they are related with the formation of igneous rock. What is the difference between lava and magma? What is referred as lava, what is referred as magma? When the materials they are coming out, unless until when they are inside the earth interior, they can be referred as the lava. When they come out, means when they come, when they reach in the crust, when they come in the touch of the atmospheric condition, that is referred as magma. So what is the difference between the lava and magma? It is clear to you. Lava, unless until the material, the liquid material, which is known as what? Which is known as the volcanic eruption, the materials which are usually comes out for what? Comes out for the formation of the earth crust, they are referred as the lava. When they reach to the crust and get solidified, they can be, or when they have the flow on the earth crust, they can be referred as magma. So igneous rocks, the first rock which used to develop on the earth crust, that is why it is also referred as igneous rocks, can be referred as primary rock. They are referred as also the primary rocks. What is the meaning of the primary rocks? As they developed very fast on the earth surface and leads to the development of the earth crust initially, that is why it is referred as the primary rocks also. It is also referred as also parent rock. It is also referred as also the parent rock. So next one, sedimentary rock. Sedimentary rock. What are the meanings of the sedimentary rock? When such igneous rocks are eroded by the action of wind, by the action of the flowing of river, by the action of sun rays or the temperature, they usually get disintegrated, means they usually break down. And they are being carried out by the some of the agents of weathering. What is weathering? Breaking down of the rocks is referred as weathering. So I am getting that the one word related to the formation of sedimentary rock, that is weathering. That is referred as weathering. What is the meaning of weathering? Weathering means breaking down of the rocks. What I told? Breaking down of the rocks. The students, I think it is clear to you. The breaking down of the rocks refers weathering. So weathered materials, when the igneous rock it is being affected and they usually breaks down, and they turns into the fragments, they are being carried out by the rivers, by the wind, glaciers, etc. And in the comparatively lesser portion of the, or the lower portion of the earth, they used to get deposited, and this is known as the sedimentation. So due to the sedimentation, when some rocks are made, they are referred as the sedimentary rocks. So what is the condition for the formation of the sedimentary rock? It is clear to you. Next one, the metamorphic rock. Metamorphic rocks. What is the meaning of the metamorphic rocks? These two rocks, that igneous as well as also sedimentary, they directly turned into the metamorphic. Metamorphic means they are totally changed in character. So when igneous or sedimentary rock, they usually get a new type of characteristics which is not familiar, which is not similar with the igneous rocks, which is not similar with the sedimentary rock. Due to the pressure and temperature of the earth interior, that is referred as the metamorphic rock. Once again, what is the process of formation of the metamorphic rock? When the igneous rock and the sedimentary rock or anyone, they used to turn into a new type of rock due to the pressure and temperature of the earth interior, that is referred as metamorphic rock. That is the process of formation of the metamorphic rock is known as the metamorphism. So I think it is clear to you. Now, the another concept we are going to discuss, that concept is referred as what? That concept is referred as the rock cycle. We are going to know about the rock cycle. What is the rock cycle? What is the meaning of rock cycle? Rock cycle refers these three rocks, they used to change their characteristics. What is this? Suppose first of all, I am taking the example of igneous rock. Igneous rocks may turn into sedimentary may turn into what? Metamorphic. Or igneous may turn into metamorphic directly, and vice versa. Means there may have the interchange in their formation, that is referred as the metamorphism, that is referred as the rock cycle. What is rock cycle? So try to understand how it is possible to get turned once again into the igneous rock. It may turn into the igneous rock. How it is possible? Due to the volcanic eruption, when the sedimentary rocks, they come under the touch of the great heat and get hit of the lava or magma, that time they can turn into what? They can turn into the igneous rock. Next one, metamorphic rock also in the same way, they can also turn into the igneous rock. So when the different rocks, they used to interchange and interchange their characteristics in a cyclic manner, they used to get changed, that is referred as the rock cycle. So this is the simplified diagram for the rock cycle. If you will get the question that what is rock cycle, explain, that time this diagram should be given. That will be more convenient to establish your answer to the evaluator. So next one, we are coming to the characteristics. Whatever yet we have not discussed, that the detailed study of the different rocks. Igneous rock, first of all we will take the example of the igneous rock. As it is made up by the lava and magma, that is why it is very easy to understand. There is no way of having organic matters, because lava or magma, they are very much hot. In that condition, there is no way of the survival of any kind of living organism. So this is one. There is no layers. We cannot find any kind of layer in the igneous rock. We cannot find any kind of layer in what? Any kind of layer in igneous rock. Next one, we are getting the porosity, means that the gap between the two particles, it is very less, because it is made up by the very fine materials. So igneous rock, it is made by the very fine materials, and whatever materials what we used to get here, they are very much clayey by the nature. And next one, we are coming to the primary sedimentary rock. What is sedimentary? Already I have told that the formation way of formation of the sedimentary rocks. That sedimentary rocks, they usually made by the lots of materials. What materials? Organic materials may also included here. That the word sedimentation is related with the sedimentary formation of the sedimentary rock. That is why we can see that there are the lots of layers. The sedimentation may take place years after years. So after the layering of the first portion, what we are getting? We are getting that the second layer, formation of the second layer, third layer, fourth layer. In this way, the sedimentary rocks, they consist the lots of layers. So if we see the example, what example? I want to show an example of the sedimentation, such type of. that example, such type of, look at the pages of the textbook. The pages of the textbook, it is layering. Means, there, suppose if we consider it is the base, this base is saying that what? The first, the second one, third one, fourth one, in this way, lots of things. Sometimes, if we keep any insects, the mosquito, suppose, if we put it, what we will get? We will get an impression of that particular substance which is going to be trapped between the layers. So in this particular layer, in this particular type of rock, we are getting also that the development of such type of minerals which are organic minerals, and they are referred as we used to get that the fossils. So fossil fuels, they can be also developed. So what is about as the fossils? Fossils may be found here. So what is the reason? At the time of layering, at the time of formation of the sedimentary rocks, layers after layers when they used to develop, some of the dead animals or the plants, they may be trapped within the sediment. So that is why that is also the possibility of the development of fossils. Fossils cannot be found in the igneous rock. So it is the most important thing. And one thing I have missed, the igneous rock, it is also made by the different types of minerals. Huge amount of concentration of the minerals, they are found in igneous rock as lava and magma bringing that the materials from the earth interior, and they are going to be settled on the earth crust as a form of the igneous rock. And mainly the plateau region, they are made by the igneous rock. In class 6 already you have learned what? Plateaus are the storehouse of different minerals. Why? As they are made up by the igneous rocks. Next one, the metamorphic rocks. We used to see that the crystallization, we used to see that the total setup change, total change in the characteristics, that leads to the formation of the metamorphic rocks. So we have discussed inside of the earth, we have also learned here the types of rocks, what is rock cycle, what is mineral, we have learned in this particular session. Have a nice day ahead.